Hello. Welcome to the 32nd commencement ceremony of Northwest Arkansas Community College for the graduating class of 2022. I'm Sivin Gallo, the Faculty Senate Representative. At the sound of the herald trumpets, the procession, arrayed in their academic regalia, will be led by Dr. Deanne Weatherspoon, Chair of the Board of Trustees and bearer of the College Mace, followed by other Board of Trustees members, college administrators, college faculty, and the candidates for graduation. Let the procession begin. Recognizing the growing need for developing interdependent communities that thrive in a global economy, NWACC utilizes education as a conduit for building connections and for fostering a culture that celebrates the principles of inclusion, understanding, and acceptance. We will now honor the American flag and the flags from countries representative of our graduates today that are displayed here on stage. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the American flag. The flag of the United States of America, presented by Mr. Drake Schwartz, NWACC Student Government Association Vice President. Ladies and gentlemen, remain standing for the performance of the national anthem by Ms. Lee Bohannon.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you very much, Lee. You may now all be seated. I am honored to introduce to you the president of Northwest Arkansas Community College. Dr. Evelyn Jorgensen became the third president of Northwest Arkansas Community College in 2013. She holds an Associate of Arts degree from State Fair Community College, a Bachelor of Fine Arts from Columbia College, and master's and doctoral degrees in higher education and adult education from the University of Missouri. Throughout her career, Dr. Jorgensen has been passionate about the contributions of community colleges. In her role as president, she continues to demonstrate that same level of passion and commitment to NWACC students. Ladies and gentlemen, with me, please welcome Dr. Evelyn Jorgensen. Dr. Jorgensen, we have some flowers for you today. I don't know if everyone knows this, but Dr. Jorgensen is retiring, and we're so happy for her, but we will certainly miss her tremendously. I started in 2013, too, so she's the only NWACC president I've ever known and truly love, and we're just going to miss you so much. So these are for you.
Oh, thank you, Savannah, for that very nice welcome. It does give me great pleasure to be part of this day of celebration. As you may have heard, remember, I also graduated from a community college, so I've been in your shoes. But this will be my last graduation as president, so I'm going to try to keep it together. Northwest Arkansas Community College has made a significant difference in thousands of lives over the past 32 years. Over 19,000 degrees and certificates have been earned by almost 14,000 graduates. We want to celebrate our many student success stories and say thank you to the community leaders, the philanthropists, the NWACC faculty and staff, all those who have played key roles in changing lives. Now it's my pleasure, great pleasure, to welcome the chair of the Board of Trustees, Dr. Deanne Witherspoon, to the podium. Dr. Witherspoon.
Good afternoon. Hello to the families, the friends, the faculty, the staff, and of course the graduating students. My name is Deanne Witherspoon. As chairperson of the NWAC Board of Trustees, and on behalf of that board, it is my distinct honor and pleasure to welcome you to this 2022 commencement ceremony for Northwest Arkansas Community College. At this time, I'd like to introduce you to a few of my other board members, so let me go ahead and do that. First, Lucas Pointer, he's hiding on the back row, and Todd Schwartz, who's also hiding on the back row. And Ellie Cunningham is our student representative. For many of you, the path to today has not been easy. You may be the first in your family to attend college, or you may have decided to return to higher education after years or decades in the workforce. I saw my own mother go back to finish college when I was 11 years old. It made a big impression on me, seeing how hard she worked and seeing the sacrifices that she made for our family. That experience taught me to do it a little bit easier and quicker way, so I consecutively did high school, college, and professional school. But that is not possible for everyone. Many of you have had endless nights studying between working, taking care of your families, and squeezing in homework. There may have been times that you struggled to persevere when it was a challenge to get a paper finished or a reading assignment done. But with determined will and a strong support system in your advisors, your professors, your family, and also your fellow students, you have succeeded, and it has paid off. I too started at a community college. It was a solid beginning of success for me. Today, we celebrate your job well done with spouses, parents, children, who may have also made sacrifices for you to be here today. Congratulations to all of you, and much success in your future.
Now I would like to introduce the rest of the stage party and ask them to stand and remain standing. Please hold your applause until introductions are completed. Dr. Savin Gallo, Faculty Senate Representative, who welcomed you earlier as today's Master of Ceremony. Dr. Ricky Tompkins, Vice President of Learning, Chief Academic Officer. Mr. Al Massery, Vice President of Finance and Administration. And Dr. Deidre Slavik, Dean of Social and Behavioral Sciences. Let's welcome them. Today we are recognizing several individuals. NWAC's Board of Trustees grants honorary associate degrees in recognition and celebration of outstanding service to the college and to the community. Honorary degrees are bestowed to select individuals who, beyond their normal occupational pursuits, exemplify a high caliber of service to enhance the quality of life for others. These degrees may be awarded for educational service, humanitarian service, servant leadership, arts and letters, and entrepreneurial leadership. At this ceremony, it is my honor to recognize one of those individuals who has made significant contributions to the college and to Northwest Arkansas. It is with great honor that the college bestows upon Mr. David Walker the honorary associate degree in entrepreneurial leadership. David immigrated from Scotland via Australia and became a U.S. citizen in 2019. After 14 years of servant leadership at Sam's Club, David established Yamalo in 2018. Yamalo specializes in candy and baking ingredients. Launching with just four items in late 2018, Yamalo is now available nationwide and is the number four brand of marshmallow in the country. David continues to put Northwest Arkansas center stage in his commitment to the greater good. David has fundraised, donated, and volunteered his time to Canopy NWA, Autism Involves Me, Saving Grace NWA, just to name a few. During the pandemic, David and his teenage daughters 3D printed PPE for first responders. He also established a namesake scholarship last year at NWACC for immigrants and their children. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. David Walker. The following awards are presented to individuals who have distinguished themselves while at NWACC. Receiving the 2022 Outstanding Graduate Award in Social and Behavioral Sciences Division is Cassie Jewell Ann Riddick. Cassie Riddick, who is graduating with an Associate of Applied Science degree in Paralegal Studies. Cassie first enrolled at NWACC in 2013, but took a break in her studies after becoming pregnant with her oldest child. She returned to NWACC in 2017 as a part-time student while working two jobs. Cassie is a first-generation college student and is a scholarship recipient from the Single Parent Scholarship Fund. In August of 2020, just days before the start of the fall 2020 semester, tragedy struck when Cassie was involved in a serious car accident that resulted in the death of her youngest child and in serious injuries to Cassie. She was hospitalized until December of that year. A couple of weeks later, in January of 2021, Cassie returned to NWACC, determined to complete her degree. She has battled through health scares and hospitalizations since then, but has remained at the top of her class and, in fact, has earned an A in every class since that terrible accident. Cassie says the paralegal program has changed her life, while the paralegal faculty uniformly praise her and her work ethic, her resiliency, her perseverance through every obstacle, and her positive attitude. Cassie is generous with her classmates, eager to participate in class, in discussions, always on time with her projects and assignments. Cassie claims that her daughter Natalie, who is now 10, has inspired her to keep going. Let us now recognize Cassie Riddick, who has served as the inspiration for the rest of us. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome today's distinguished graduate, Cassie Jewell Ann Riddick.
thank you so much to everyone, faculty, friends, family, everyone, Professor Kim Coates, Dr. Jorgensen, the entire committee. I just want to tell everyone that I'm so honored and thankful to be given this award and to be this year's distinguished graduate. I also wanted to talk about our other graduates we have here today. Let's give them a round of applause because they made it too. So today I want to talk a little bit about overcoming obstacles, perseverance, and success. I came from very humble beginnings. I'm a first-generation college student, and I didn't get the opportunity to go to college straight out of high school. In fact, I went straight into the workforce. The job that I had for 5 years, one day came to me and said, "We are going to be downsizing, and unfortunately, Cassie, you don't have a degree, so we can't keep you." The truth was, the truth hurt. And at the time, I was a single mother with two little girls, working two jobs. I didn't know what I was going to do. So I took those words, and I decided to come enroll in NWACC. I didn't have the money to even pay for one semester of college. But I decided I was going to try anyway. And so I used the funds from my second job to pay for that first semester. In 2013, I could only afford to go to one class, but I did my best in that one class. A few months later, I became pregnant, and my daughter had some health issues, so I had to leave NWACC. But I made a promise to myself that no matter how long it took, I would come back. It took 2 years to come back for that second semester. That second semester was truly hard. I got up every day at 6 a.m., and sometimes I didn't go to bed till 2 a.m. On top of homework, work, and taking care of babies, I didn't think I was going to make it. But then I started meeting some really wonderful people. I got introduced to career services. I decided to change my major to the paralegal program, and I decided that I was going to take my opportunity at NWACC and make a career for myself. Everything was going great for the next few semesters. And then, in August 2020, just 2 days before classes started, I was involved in a life-threatening car accident. Not many of you that know this, but my youngest daughter was killed in that accident. She was only 6. My oldest daughter, Natalie, survived. And so together we tried to put back the pieces of our broken life. I spent 4 months in the hospital, 7 weeks in ICU, most of them on a ventilator. When I did finally come to, a team of doctors told my family, if she does survive, she will never speak again and she will never walk again. In fact, they gave me 1% survival rate. My family didn't accept those terms, and neither did I. So I decided that I was going to try my best, no matter what it took. I was going to get my voice back, I was going to get my knowledge back, and I was going to do whatever it took to keep going and finish school. So just 1 month after being out of the hospital, I went back to class. And it was so hard. There were days when I just wanted to give up, and I would cry, and I felt sorry for myself. And then one day, all that changed when my 10-year-old daughter, Natalie, who's in the audience tonight, wave, Natalie. She asked me one morning, she said, "Mom, why are you crying?" And I didn't have the heart to tell her. And she said, "You know, Mom, today my teacher told me, what do you want to be, Natalie? What do you want to be when you grow up?" And Natalie said, "Oh, I don't know what I want to be when I grow up, but I do know that I want to graduate college just like my mom." And I asked Natalie, I said, "Why did you say that?" And she said, "Because I wanted my teacher to know that you never give up." And that is what you have to do sometimes. So you know what? After that, I got stronger, and I used NWACC as an outlet for my recovery. I found some really good outlets in the music department. Frida Goodman helped me with my speech through singing. Paul Price, I got to join the rock band, so that was a lot of fun. There was a lot of awesome activities that I used as an outlet to help with my recovery. So here I am today, standing in front of you, getting to make this wonderful speech and getting this wonderful award. And you know what? All those obstacles don't matter now, because here I am today. Here we all are today. We've made it through COVID. We've made it through a lot these last 2 years. So, you know, I'm not the only one that's tried and failed. Some major celebrities, including Walt Disney, who was told a mouse would actually scare children, Mickey Mouse. Now he has a Disney empire. Did you know that Oprah Winfrey was told that she was unfit for TV? She had one of the longest running talk shows and is one of the richest women in the world. One of my favorite shows, I Love Lucy, the star of that, Lucia Ball, was told that that show would be a flop and it would never get past the pilot episode. Do you know that that show has been playing for 70 years? Wow. One other fact I'd like to share is about an author, J.K. Rowling, the author of the Harry Potter series. She was just like me, a broke single mother living on welfare, trying to make it through college. Now she's a billionaire. So, you know, don't let people tell you that you can't do something. If you believe that you can do it, you will. There's a quote from President Theodore Roosevelt that says, "Strength is courage. Courage is not having the strength to go on. It is going on when you don't have the strength." So no matter what obstacle stands before you, no matter what tragedies you face, no matter what problems or how late you had to stay up doing homework or how many times you've ate ramen noodles, because we've all done that, I'm sure, just remember, perseverance is key. And if you believe in yourself, you will make it. Thank you all so much.
Thank you so much. Very inspiring for all of us. Mr. Jerry Rose is the coordinator of the Criminal Justice Program and has served in that capacity for over 17 years. Professor Rose was a graduate of Little Rock University, which is now the University of Arkansas at Little Rock. He is a Fulbright scholar. He has a graduate degree from Victoria University of Wellington, New Zealand, and a law degree from Stetson College of Law. Prior to his time at Northwest Arkansas Community College, Professor Rose was the elected city attorney of Fayetteville and served as an assistant attorney general for the state of Arkansas. Jerry is married to Holly Rose, who's graced him with a daughter and three wonderful grandchildren. In addition to his professional accomplishments, Professor Rose is a friend and colleague who brightens the day of all who have the privilege of knowing him. Ladies and gentlemen, today's distinguished faculty member, Mr. Jerry Rose.
My goodness, thank you. Madam President, board members, fellow faculty, my wife is up there. I have to say hi to her. My daughter is there. My son-in-law is there. I have three of the most wonderful grandchildren in the entire world that are up there, and two very close friends, and their wives are also up there to cheer me on. How wonderful that truly is. I am incredibly honored to stand before you this afternoon as the outstanding faculty member for this year, an award I humbly accept, knowing so many of my faculty peers are considerably more qualified than I. Today, I want to speak to just the graduating class of 2022. The rest of you are welcome to listen if you would like, but I want to speak just to the group of graduates. I'm here to ask you to take one more course before leaving NWAC. That course is called Your Life. And I want to present to you the text for that course as my graduation present to you. I realize that that's a bit presumptuous. After all, this is your life and you can do with it whatever you want or desire, but let me at least try and explain. My students know, and I see some of you, that I always have them explore the author of their textbooks to determine that author's background, both academic and personal, and to explain their perspective in writing their text. Let me tell you about the author of the text I present today to you as a gift. You may have some things in common with that author. He was the first person in his immediate family to graduate from high school, much less college. He loathed high school. He did poorly. He flunked French. He learned to shoot pool. He was advised to find employment, perhaps filling cigarette machines, or learning to marry well. His dysfunctional family, who simply wanted him to get a job and get out of the house, discouraged any thought of going to college. Regardless, and mainly because of peer pressure, he tried a semester at a commuter college in his hometown. To his surprise, he prospered. He learned the pleasure of learning from some gifted, dedicated, and engaging professors. He discovered student politics. His academic achievements far exceeded those of high school. At the end of 4 years, he graduated as you have today. He found himself fortunate enough to study abroad as a Fulbright scholar, obtained a law degree, and learned, truly by trial and error, how to marry well. There's more, but that brings us up to the book I present to you for your course. You may have figured out by now that the author of this text is me. The book is filled with chapters containing 77 years of experiences. Some successes, many failures, some unique experiences that, like the honor of addressing you today, far exceed my expectations when I began to write. I reread some of the chapters and discovered many things I wanted to accomplish that I now must leave to you, the graduates of 2020. Many of the challenges in my text are still there after almost 60 years. They have not changed. In addition, you have new and more potentially dystopian ones to add to your book. While I apologize to you for my generation's failures and they are many. I have no doubt that you will succeed. It's not original, but my father always advised me that I should make a bet at least once a day. Otherwise, I could be on a lucky streak and not know it. That's the title of the latest chapter in my book. But it's not about luck. It's about challenges, about faith. Faith in you. I have had some wonderful people take a chance on me, not the least of which was hiring me 17 years ago to teach at NWACC. I now, along with everyone in this auditorium, choose to take a chance on you, the graduates of 2022. Faith that you have the ability to write a better book than your parents, a better book than your peers, and all of us here today that seek to honor you. We want to read your book. We want it to be filled with happiness, knowledge of what is true, and wisdom beyond your years. We want your book to have chapters on how you and your generation have faced the problems my generation has left you. Problems of health, cancer, pandemics, climate change, pollution, race relations, how to live in peace, how to conquer hatred, how to end child abuse, how to reduce poverty, how to reduce crime. The list seems endless. It is not. You can succeed. Where we and my generation have failed, and we have unwavering faith that you will. Never underestimate yourself or your own power. You have hundreds of NWACC employees gathered today in this auditorium who had only one purpose, and that is for you to be the best that you can be. From the professors who taught you, to administrators who catered to your problems and your needs, to those who have built buildings and filled them with the very best of educational tools, to those who kept those buildings clean for you and functioning, to those who sought to advise you, to assist you in scholarships and loans. It was all for you. You. To have this many people in one place at one time, and they have no purpose but to encourage and care about the book that you will write over the course of your life, is incredibly rare. Indeed, it may never happen again to you. Enjoy it. Savor it. Add chapter after chapter after chapter in remembrance of your accomplishment. So, congratulations on your graduation. And now, go write your book.
Thank you. and now it's the time that we've been waiting for. Representing the faculty of Northwest Arkansas Community College, would Dr. Deirdre Slavik, the board chair, and the college president please step forward to congratulate the candidates as they receive their diplomas.
We will now begin our presentation of candidates. To honor the health and safety of our graduates, faculty, staff, and the entire NWAC community, your diplomas will be received without a handshake or physical contact. We ask that you please respect this request. Graduates, please proceed to the stage. Johnson, Associate General Studies, Cum Laude, Certificate General Studies, Cum Laude. Reed Novotny, Associate of General Studies, Summa Cum Laude, Certificate General Studies with Special Distinction. Catherine Detter, Associate of General Studies, Magna Cum Laude, Certificate General Studies with Distinction. Devan Brook Lesher, Associate of Science, Agriculture, Food and Life Sciences, Cum Laude. Stout, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, STEM. Maritza Montserrat Gonzalez, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, Magna Cum Laude, Associate of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Michaela Ellender, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, Magna Cum Laude, Honors Program Candidate. June Ellen Bray, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM. Jessica Montserrat Vasquez Perez, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, Magna Cum Laude. Alicia Tamisha Lindo, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, Cum Laude. Technical Certificate, Pre-Health Sciences, Certificate of Proficiency, Child Advocacy Studies. Nicole Elizabeth Gomez, Associate of Science, Civil Arts and Sciences, non-STEM. Jennifer Elizabeth Helinski, Associate of Science, Civil Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, cum laude. Paola Guadalupe Galdames, Associate of Science, Civil Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, cum laude. Lombri Pearl Phillips, Associate of Science, Civil Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, magna cum laude. Certificate of Proficiency, Child Advocacy Studies with Distinction. Lisbeth Alexis Zenobio, Associate of Science, Civil Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, cum laude. Certificate, General Studies. Daniel Eduardo Mitre Gonzalez, Associate of Science, Civil Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, cum laude. Kaden Lee Meredith, Associate of Science, Civil Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, Associate of General Studies. Anna Maybell Anderson, Associate of Science, Civil Arts and Sciences, non-STEM. Jaden Elizabeth Grindley, Associate of Science, Civil Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, magna cum laude. Juan Daniel Salas, Associate of Science, Civil Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, cum laude. Christy Ann Baird, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, cum laude. Certificate, General Studies. Emily R. Sanchez, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, magna cum laude. Associate of Arts, magna cum laude. Jessica Martinez, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, cum laude. Cesar Perez, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, STEM. Stacy Marquez, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, magna cum laude. Chalene Marie Miller, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, magna cum laude. Associate of Arts, magna cum laude. Certificate, General Studies with Distinction, Honors Program Certificate. Honors Program Graduate. Lauren Elizabeth Leonard, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, cum laude. Ashley Fuentes, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences, non-STEM, cum laude, Child Advocacy Studies certificates of proficiency. Genesis Hernandez, Associate of Science, Civil Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Child Advocacy Studies, certificate of proficiency. Brittany Torres, Associate of Science, Civil Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Cum Laude, Associate of General Studies, Cum Laude, Certificate General Studies. Brittany Baker, Associate of Science, Civil Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Summa Cum Laude, Certificate General Studies with Special Distinction. Alejandro Lopez, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Cum Laude. Julia Isabel Cruz, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Summa Cum Laude, Associate of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Jack Wen, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Cum Laude. Ruby Reyes, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Cum Laude. Daisy Vargas, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Magna Cum Laude. Associate of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Associate of General Studies, Magna Cum Laude. Certificate General Studies with distinction. Vicky Marisol Duarte, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Magna Cum Laude. Associate of Science, Magna Cum Laude. London Waters Taylor, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Magna Cum Laude. Victoria Rose Barnes, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, of Science and Sciences Non-STEM, Magna Cum Laude. Associate of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Madison Nicole Stenfield, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Magna Cum Laude. Mallory Anderson, Associate of Science, Civil Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Magna Cum Laude. Artisha Unique Jones, Associate of Science, Civil Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Summa Cum Laude. Jessica Brenham, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Summa Cum Laude. Ashton Reed Pistulka, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, Cum Laude. Elizabeth Tolbert, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM. Isaac Spiva, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM, cum laude. Stanley Salvador Rodriguez, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM, Associate of Arts. Dahlia Monharis, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM, cum laude. Ashley Bookham, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM. Karen Adriana Gonzalez Velleda, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM, cum laude. Zachary Austin Killian, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM. Rhonda Lynn Hazen, magna cum laude, Associate of General's Honors Program, magna cum laude, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM, magna cum laude. Matthew Jordan Petty, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences STEM, summa cum laude. Associate of Arts, summa cum laude. Certificate General Studies with special distinction. Kelly Guadalupe Martinez Rodriguez, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM, magna cum laude. Karen Adaya Rocha Monroy, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM. Isabel Perea, Associate of Applied Science, Early Childhood Education, cum laude, Technical Certificate, Early Childhood Education, Certificate of Proficiency, Child Development Associate. Natalie Zamora, Associate of Applied Science, Early Childhood Education, cum laude, Technical Certificate, Early Childhood Education, Certificate of Proficiency, Child Development Associate. Jessica Ibarra, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM, cum laude, Certificate of Proficiency, Child Development Associate. Haley Smith, Associate of Applied Science, Early Childhood Education, magna cum laude. Esmeralda Aldaco, Associate of Applied Science, Early Childhood Education. Anita Moss, Associate of Arts, Child Advocacy Studies, summa cum laude. Abigail Bartista, Associate of Arts, Child Advocacy Studies, Associate of Science, Liberal Arts and Sciences Non-STEM. Michael Kevin Maldonado, Associate of Applied Science, Paralegal Studies. Monserrate Hernandez Zamacona, Associate of Applied Science, Paralegal Studies, cum laude. Jasmine Thurstio Cornejo, Associate of Applied Science, Paralegal Studies, magna cum laude. Casey Jewel N. Riddick, Associate of Applied Science, Paralegal Studies, magna cum laude. Roxana Andrade, Certificate of Proficiency, Criminal Justice, with distinction. Autumn Nicole Kolb, Associate of Applied Science, Criminal Justice, cum laude, Technical Certificate, Criminal Justice, Certificate of Proficiency, Criminal Justice, Certificate of Proficiency, Workforce Readiness. Christine Rose Bromley, Associate of Applied Science, Criminal Justice, magna cum laude. Associate of Science, Civil Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, magna cum laude. Certificate of Proficiency, Criminal Justice. Brianne Alice Kleins, Associate of Applied Science, Criminal Justice, Certificate of Proficiency, Criminal Justice, Technical Certificate, Criminal Justice. Deandra Dawn Strickland, Associate of Science, Civil Arts, and Sciences Non-STEM, magna cum laude. Associate of Applied Science, Criminal Justice, magna cum laude. Technical Certificate, Criminal Justice, with distinction. Certificate of Proficiency, Criminal Justice, with distinction. Justin Tyler Soto, Associate of Applied Science, Criminal Justice, Technical Certificate, Criminal Justice, Certificate of Proficiency, Criminal Justice. This concludes the presentation of candidates. I offer my congratulations to each one of you for the significant accomplishment being celebrated here today. Your hard work and the personal sacrifices you made in reaching this important plateau are a true reflection of both your abilities and commitment. You are now in a position to make a significant difference in the world. And I wish you continued success and prosperity.
Members of the administration and Board of Trustees, as Vice President of Learning and Chief Academic Officer at Northwest Arkansas Community College, it is my distinct pleasure and privilege to present the members of the 2022 graduating class. Will the candidates for the graduating class of 2022 please rise?
By the power vested in the Board of Trustees by the State of Arkansas, I hereby confer upon you the associate degrees and professional certificates with all the rights and privileges appertaining thereunto. Congratulations. You may move your tassel over your left eye. Graduates, please remain standing and repeat after me the NWACC alumni oath provided in the program. As an NWACC graduate, I commit myself to lifelong learning. As an NWACC graduate, I pledge to apply the skills, knowledge, and values from my NWACC experience. I apply skills, knowledge, and values from my NWACC experience. As I engage and improve the enterprises for which I work and the communities in which I live, I acknowledge that I am now forever part of the NWACC family. And will proudly help sustain NWACC's legacy for future generations. You are now a lifelong member of the NWACC family, and we hope you will consider becoming an active member of the NWACC Alumni Association. If you've not already done so, please be sure to pick up your gift from the Alumni Association before leaving today. Graduates, you have accomplished so much during your educational journey here at Northwest Arkansas Community College. You are to be congratulated. At this time, please prepare for the recessional. Guest, as the graduates prepare to exit, please remain seated until faculty and graduates have completed the traditional recessional from the auditorium. You may meet your graduates in the lobby or the reception area. Dr. Witherspoon, please begin the recessional. Thank you.